Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm doing very well today, especially well because the YouTube community, the channel on YouTube, is giving me some great ideas for demos, which I absolutely love. Case in point, a letter a couple of weeks ago, or a post a couple of weeks ago, from Chris Stearns, who says, as usual, good stuff, do I use Sidekick or Ginger? I did a video about grammar software, and he wasn't sure if it was me that turned him on to Ginger or not. In point of fact, I did do a demo on grammar software because my grammar always needs help, but it was on Grammarly. It wasn't on Ginger. Grammarly's still a really good tool, which I quite like, but Chris spoke in such glowing terms of Ginger, I thought I better have a look at it. It's available for Mac Mail as a Safari extension or as also in Chrome, but it's also a tool that installs on our smartphone, so I thought I would have a look. And Chris has hit on something. Ginger, an outstanding app. It's really a keyboard that does grammar and spell checking and sentence rephrasing for us. But I think it's a tool that's well worth looking at. So thanks so much to Chris. We're going to take a look at Ginger today on Dotto Tech. I absolutely love it when the YouTube community comes up with good ideas and demos of products that they think is valuable, asks me to share it with the community, and I also think it's valuable. Case in point, this Ginger, which is, it can be a little bit confusing. When I first looked at it, it took me a few minutes to get my head around it, so let me explain it to you. Just be patient for a moment. Ginger, in its raw form, is a keyboard. It's a add-on keyboard that you add to your smartphone, like the emoji keyboards. So you add on a keyboard that gives you some different skins, some different looks, but it also has some intelligence and technology built into it to help you with spell and grammar checking. It'll also help you do word rephrasing and a couple of other tools that are built into it. It's available free, but there's also premium versions that do a little bit more for you. Now, that is it in the mobility space, which I will show you in just a moment. It's also a tool that is on your desktop, but it doesn't install at the operating system level. Instead, it's a browser plugin on the desktop level or your notebook, which is where we will start our look at Ginger. So it's not going to work, say, in Microsoft Word, but it will work when you are working on any documents in your web browser, which, of course, we are doing increasingly. We're increasingly working on documents in our web browser. Now, Ginger installs as a browser add-on or plugin, and here it is in Chrome. I've got it running here in Chrome, and you can see we've got a little icon here for Ginger. If I click on that, it will pop out a little editor, and it's like a little notepad that we can work with, and you can use this to write different things and then copy and paste them or move them into different documents that you're going to work on. So you can copy into documents, and it does spell checking and those sorts of things for us. And now I probably made some. Yes, I did. I made it good. I'm glad I made a mistake. I made several mistakes. So you see how what Ginger does is it shades everything blue as it tries to clear it up for us. And then it allows you to just hover your mouse over top and then just either click on what it is you want it to check to fix, or you notice there was also a plus there. If it's a proper name or a word that's unique to your industry, you can then add it to your Ginger dictionary so that you can have access to it in the future. Now, if we look in the little bar here in the side in the drop-down, we see that Ginger does a few other things for us just straight out of the box, including doing translate. So it does a very similar job to what we've looked at in the past in Google Translate, but it's nice and convenient because it's right here. It'll offer you definitions, synonyms. It'll allow you to create favorites, which are little text snippets. You copy it and you save it as a text snippet. Great for signatures and things like addresses. It's not a tool that I'm going to use. I'm not going to use the favorite tool because I'm such a big fan of using the tool Text Expander, which I've shown you in a video. It's a keyboard shortcut and a macro tool. So anything that I want to save that's a text snippet that I want to use over and over again, I will choose to use Text Expander for that. But it's nice to have it here, especially if you don't invest in Text Expander. It gives you some other options. It also helps train. It's supposed to be a very good ESL tool where people are learning to speak English. It's supposed to be excellent for that sort of thing. And then it's got a few extra other features, including some tutorials built into it. Now, on the desktop itself, it's a glorified spell checker. It does a better job, I would say, and I like the interface a little bit better than the built-in spell checkers, but we've got a variety of those sorts of spell checkers built into our desktop. So the incremental value of Ginger on the desktop is not as great as what we're going to see on our smartphone. Although with these additions additional grammar tools, it is nice, and it does check your grammar and your spelling, of course, as you go. But let's jump across, and let me show you it running on your smartphone. Now, on your smartphone, Ginger has a tool, or an app, I'll call it, which is called Pages, which if I open it up, it's called the Ginger Page. It's not called Pages. It's called the Ginger Page. And what it is it's a simple little text editor that gives you access to pretty much all of Ginger's tools that I can write in. As I'm writing my notes from the last meeting, I am thinking, and watch what happens. One of the nice things that I like about it is as you type it in, it's got a wonderful predictive text capability. Do you see how the word thinking is right there in the center? It adds those things to us as we go. It adds suggestions as you go along to the note. So you just start typing the words and you will slowly develop a little bit of a different typing technique than just firing away on the keyboard. You'll be kind of having half an eye on this bar here in the middle that you can, oh, there it is, that you can try and make work. There we go. Do you see how it's all kind of just working for me as far as it goes? Now, of course, that's not a great sentence as far as grammar goes, but you get an idea of how this predictive text really does help. And it's a kind of an autofill, and it's not quite as bad as Apple's autocorrect, which has embarrassed so many of us so many times and caused us probably the most fun we can ever have on Facebook looking at other people's damn you autocorrect files. Having said all of that, these tools within Ginger are make it quite appealing. Now, this keyboard, the Ginger keyboard that I'm working on here, this can also install for all of our other iOS apps. So we install it either in Android or on our iOS device. We install it at a system level on the device. So now when I'm in my texting tool or when I'm in my own editor, any other editor, I have access to the Ginger keyboard. And if I look here in the Ginger page, I see, does this look familiar? It's pretty much the same menu system that we saw on the desktop system. So that's quite nice. But you can also choose all of these different themes. This is one of the things that they think is a big deal. I don't know if I'm that concerned about the look of my keyboard. I mean, I like a keyboard to look nice and clean and to seem very useful, but you can actually even design your own theme if you happen to want it. But I just like kind of like the standard theme. I think that they've kind of thought it out well. And the Ginger keyboard itself looks pretty nice to me. I think it looks just great, and I like that dark one against the black face of my iPhone has a black face, so I like that for that. So you have that there, so you're able to turn this on so that you can use the same keyboard in other tools or in other apps. Now, the other thing, though, is once you're typing in the Ginger pages, you often want to take this from the Ginger page. And obviously, you want to use this text in some other app. So what you see there is my chat, my texting app, in the right-hand side. That's because it's the last thing that I copied it into. If I tap on that up arrow right there, it allows me to choose my main apps in order to migrate this text into, or I can indeed even go in and I can copy it into other apps, which I can activate a relationship within Ginger, or I can also just copy the text, in which case I can paste it into anything that I want. So we've got lots of different potential as far as moving it out of the Ginger app, because obviously the Ginger page would be just used at this point as a composition tool, and then we would end up moving it into whatever app we actually want to deliver or store the text in. Overall, I've only been using it for about a week. A couple of weeks ago that I got the email that recommended me take a look at it. I wanted to wait until I got the new iPhone, which I've just had for a few days. But now that I've got the new iPhone and I've got the Ginger app, I gotta say, I kind of like the Ginger app. I think they've done a really good job with it. And in fact, I think that they've done such a good job that I am thinking about buying it. Now, they've got it on sale right now. Depending on when you look at this, it costs from $10 a month, $100 a year. In this case here, I'm going to get it for about $50, I think, for the year. And it tells you what you get. There's the premium and the basic version. The big difference is the premium version, I think, is a real help, especially if English is not your first language. With the sentence rephraser, it'll read back the text to you, which is a great proofreading feature, by the way, is having the text read back to you. I do like that. It can also practice on your mistakes. So it really helps you work and learn to craft English more effectively. Whereas I'm really most interested and it just helping me by catching my mistakes and giving me access to the keyboards and the grammar checking and that sort of stuff. So it does a good job from that perspective. It's different than the other apps that I've looked at, being very keyboard-based. But the nice thing is, with that keyboard base, being able to access the tools, the main features of it, from within some of the different apps, certainly when we're in the browser or we're on the keyboard, being able to access it at that point there makes it, in my mind, a very appealing app. So I gotta say a big, huge thanks to Chris for recommending we take a look at Ginger. Indeed, it is a great piece of software. You've also told me that you want me to take a look at Sidekick. I think I better pay attention to what Chris is recommending. I'll have a look at Sidekick, and maybe in a month or so we might have a demo coming down the pipe for Sidekick. Because so far, the advice from Chris, rock solid. That is all the time that we have for today's demo. I hope you found it useful. Remember, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is, please subscribe to this channel. Second, subscribe to our newsletter. Then you hear about upcoming live events and webinars that we have, of which we do about one a week, and usually they are just jam-packed with useful information. So make sure you're on the newsletter list so you hear notice of those. And finally, Dotto Tech is brought to you by our community through Patreon. We're a crowdfunded site. If you wanted to find out a little bit more about what Patreon represents and what it means to be a supporter of Dotto Tech and what you get in return, and there are perks which are awesome, I encourage you to take a look at our Patreon page. That is it. I am done for today. I'm Steve Dotto. Till next time, have fun storming a castle.